Hello student, I welcome you all in today's session. In today's session, we are going to consider the very important poem in your third unit, that is The Will to Win. I have already explained what is the meaning of will in the previous session. Will means desire and win means to get success. So if we have a desire to get success in the life, then what kind of things we have to do, we have to understand in this poem. So without making any kind of delay, let's consider the poem. But before that, we will try to understand about the poem. The poet of this particular poem is Barton Bale. He was born in Madison, which is part of the Wisconsin, USA. He is American poet. And what happened? He inherited his father's talent was there. What kind of talent he had? He had a talent in writing. And this talent was reflected at a very young age, when he was just of 11 years. What he did at the age of 11 years, he published one book, or his first work, we can say. The title of that book was Why the Grass is Green. And as this book is a story collection of fairy tales, so Bale is also considered a person who always optimistic and held the belief that everything is possible. So here it is, you can see now. Bale has written around 4,000 verses means poems, and several hundred, here you can see now, the several hundreds short stories. You can understand the short stories are there, right? And because of his contribution towards the literature, he is most widely read American poet of his era. Era means his period. Now, in this poem, what we have to understand, the poet has given a message regarding the success, how we can get success, or the poet want to teach that if we have a will to win, right, what kind of things we have to do. So let us begin this particular poem. So look at now, in the first stanza, the poet want to say, if you want a thing bad enough, go out and fight for it. Work day and night for it, and give up your time and your peace, your sleep for it. So look at now, if you want to get success, if you want to achieve something, is there, the poet want to, you should go and fight for means you have to work for that particular thing. How? For day and night, means you should not take the rest until you will get the success, or until you achieve the that particular thing. For this purpose, you have to give up. Give up means to live. What kind of things we have to live in order to get the success? We have to live what? Your time, your peace, and your sleep. These things we have to live. Generally, these things, if we are not living, then there is no possibility of getting any kind of success. So therefore, the poet is insisting in the first stanza, you should leave these things, you should try to get rid from these things, then and then there is a chance of getting success, right? In the second stanza, if you all that your dream and scheme is about it, and life seems useless and worthless without it. So look at now, scheme, the meaning of the word scheme means plan is there. Here you can see now, the plan is there. So definitely, what kind of your dream is there? If you want to achieve that dream, you should prepare a roadmap of your plan, or you can make a plan to achieve your dream is there. And if you don't have any kind of plan is there, then your dream is useless. The poet is saying in this way. In the next line, what the poet want to say? If you gladly sweat for E, for freight, for plan for it, and lose all your terror of opposition for it, definitely. So look at now, here the word sweat is there. Sweat means when if you are doing any kind of laborious work, any kind of hard work is there, at that time the sweat will come out. Sweat means gham. And similarly, if you want to achieve your dream, if you want to get success, then you should prepare yourself for doing hard work, right? Fret means, the meaning of fret means you should not worry about other things. You should prepare your plan, and you should forget all the things related with the fear that is being created in your mind because of the oppositions. Understand? So only you have to concentrate on your goal. That is the most important thing in order to get success. Now we will move to the next lines are there. If you simply go after that things that you want with all your capacity, strength, sagacity, faith, hope, and confidence, and stern pertinacity. So look at now, if you want to complete your dream, achieve your dream, then these things you have to follow here, right? You should believe on your capacity, you should concentrate on your dream with the help of your strength. Understand, the sagacity, the meaning of sagacity means we have to take appropriate decision and good judgment we have to take in order to get the success. Then apart from this one, faith is very important, hope is also important there, and most important things which are required for the success is confidence and stern pertinacity. So what is meant by the pertinacity? Pertinacity means constant determination is there. Means sometimes we are determining, but we are not maintaining the continuity or consistency in that determination, and therefore what happened? Sometime we may get fail in achieving our dream. Similarly, the poet is giving, and what is there? He is telling you very important things and the qualities which are required for achieving the success in this particular stanza. Now, let's move to the next line. If neither cold or poverty, famished or grunt. So look at now, these are some of the challenges that you may find in your, or these may be the hurdles in your success, right? If neither cold, poverty, famished means extremely hunger, and grunt means very thin, or especially because of the disease, hunger or cold. So look at now, these are some of the challenges, these are some of the hurdles in your success. If neither cold or poverty, famished or grunt, or sickness or pain of body or brain can keep you away from the thing that you want. Yes, if you follow the things which are already mentioned in the poem by the poet, then definitely if there is cold, there is poverty, famished, these things will not stop you from achieving your success. Now let's move to the last two lines there. If dodged and grim, so look at now, if dodged and grim, be sage, be if dodged and grim, you be sage and be set it, with the help of God you shall get it, definitely. So all these things in the last two lines, the poet is giving some optimistic expectations that if dodged means continuously, if you are handling your dream, if you are continuously pursuing your dream, then definitely whatever may be the seriousness, whatever may be unhappiness is there, right? It is surrounded by, you are surrounded by any kind of unhappiness or seriousness, then definitely it will not prevent you from getting the success, because you are going to achieve the success with the help of the God, that you shall get it. Understand? So God is also helping you. Even God will also not prevent you from getting the success. In this way, the poet has given you the message of be optimistic and be continuous. In this poem, the poet has used different types of words right from the beginning. Here you can see now, some words are given there, which these words are very important in order to convey the meaning of this poem is there, right? So I hope you understood all these things which are mentioned in the poem, and you will also try to receive the message which is given by the poem. Thank you.